I'm Jessica Braithwaite and you're watching PNTV.
Hi, my name is Sean.
And my name is Ben.
Welcome to PNTV.
Today we have a very special guest.
Please welcome Jessica Braithwaite with the weather for this weekend.
Hello, welcome to PNTV. I'm Jessica Braithwaite and we're here to do a very special weather report tonight with Maddie, Buddhima and Ava. So take it away, girls.
This week it has been extremely hot. Luckily, it's cooling down.
And this weekend's weather will be pleasant, not too hot or not too cold.
This weekend we'll also be saying goodbye to summer and waking up to brand new autumn.
My favourite season is autumn. I can't wait for some milder weather in Adelaide. And thank you so much, guys. I know who to call now when we need a fill-in weather presenter.
An egg just hatched.
So many people's come up and so the egg hatched. We have three eggs now. We have three chicks now.
Brought 12 eggs and an incubator to school.
We marked on our calendar when they should hatch. It takes about 21 days.
The first chick hatched on day 20.
Five hatched all together and we got to watch one hatch.
It was very exciting to watch it hatch.
Now we have to fix the chicken coop.
Every day at school, we acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we learn and play. In our first few weeks of school, room 6 and 7 used our school value of curiosity to answer questions we had about the acknowledgments of country.
We talked about where we see acknowledgments take place and discussed the importance of the acknowledging traditional owners.
We learned the difference between an acknowledgement and a welcome to country.
After viewing a variety of different acknowledgement, we made a list of what we thought it needed to have and wrote a acknowledgement in groups.
We then pull all of our ideas together to come up with our room 7 acknowledgement of country.
We have painted leaves that we found in our schoolyard that we will use to display our acknowledgement. Our next step is to put it all together and display it in our classroom.
So you obviously work in front of a green screen, but how do you know where each state or area is located while broadcasting?
Yeah, so we actually, at the moment at Channel 9, we actually have, it's not a green screen, it's a big LED sort of a plasma screen, but it's similar to a green screen in the sense that I can't see it when we're going to air, so the numbers are behind me, and even though it might look like I'm pointing to the maps, I can't actually see them because they're behind me. So what I have is another monitor that is in front of me, so it would be here, which shows me what's happening behind me. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Oh, so it kind of like mirrors it.
That's right, yeah. Yep. So I can see when I make a movement, I can see that on the other camera, and that then sort of reflects back to me what I'm doing. So I'm kind of using that as my guide, so I know where to point. And there's places that are harder to point to than others because you sort of don't want to cover the maps, and there's a bit of an art to it. But after a while, you do sort of get into a bit of a flow.